It still fascinates me.
The incredible beauty of the universe.
I call it a marathon and not a sprint.
We never wanted to be in second place.
Whatever I wanted to do, I felt that I could do it.
I'm dreaming about nothing less than a revolution in medicine.
Francis Collins's dreams were always a mix of the big and the creative. There was no bigger or more creative effort than the Human Genome Project.
The Human Genome Project was this audacious effort to read out all of the 3 billion letters of the human DNA instruction book.
Manuals serve as our guidepost to understand the operation of all types of machinery. It was in the human genome that we gained the manual to the most complex machine of all.
Almost every scientific problem I've worked on, I encountered first as a physician and found it fascinating and frustrating that the disease that I was trying to help somebody with had so little known about it.
Collins's early efforts as a decoder were with cystic fibrosis, a devastating disease afflicting the lungs of children and young people.
Having spent more than 5 years chasing down just one gene, the cystic fibrosis gene, it was clear that unless we had this kind of a database about our own instruction book, we were not going to make much headway in the coming years. I came to the conclusion there was only one Human Genome Project. It was only going to happen once in all of history. And how could I turn down the chance to stand at the helm of something of this kind of significance and move it forward? People, I think, have forgotten how controversial the Genome Project was in its early days. The majority of scientists opposed it. It was a tough sell.
As the leader of the U.S. genome effort, Collins found himself in the midst of what developed into the genome battle, from a debate about approach to even whose genome should be mapped.
When history looks back at the Genome Project, I think the commentary will reflect both the science, because it was amazing science, but also this notion of giving the data away as a new paradigm. Some of my greatest joys as a scientist have been working in a team where you unleashed the creative juices of the people involved and discovered something that otherwise would not have been possible.
As the director of the National Institutes of Health, today Collins leads a team of 18,000 shaping our nation's biomedical future.
But anybody who's listening to these words who feels like, gosh, you know, I guess I missed the best part because we've already passed the peak of the most exciting science. Don't worry, it still lies ahead.